American Family.
Sure.
First song.
Highlight for me, the cougar. So there's a bit in the song where we were just doing some vocal
ad libs.
And I did this scream. We put some echo on it and some reverb, and we found out it kind of sounded like a cougar.
Yeah, the next song's called Hometown. It gets people moving around and dancing and stuff at gigs, man, and that's always a good look, you know, when you sort of put your head up and see what's going on out there and everyone's going crazy, and it's usually to Hometown because it's so sort of up-tempo, loads of energy.
Danger, probably our most retrospective track, do you know what I mean? It harks back to more of kind of like the heritage of soul.
It's a lot of fans' favourite, I think, that one.
All I wanted was Danger, I mean, like, you. It's a good line. You come up with a line like that, and it's like the song just sort of builds around it. An obvious first single, isn't it?
Yeah, and it kind of, you know, that track helped just get a record.
It's about
one of my faves.
The original album opener, isn't it?
When we were in the studio, we conceived this to be track one.
Yeah, you see, it's the first introduction of like in the album of our love of sort of ska and reggae. Yeah, number five. Matter.
Matter. Highlight for me.
Yeah.
Big tune.
Nothing but matter.
Big summer fun.
For me, the outro sounds like Notting Hill Carnival. It's just absolute mayhem.
And it was real, wasn't it? It was real.
Yeah, that was all live.
B Roads.
There is such a lovely vibe.
It's proper classic hip hop beats. In that one.
Anytime you listen to the album, post B Roads, you know you're going down sort of a darker alley at this point.
Then we hit Kimmy.
And again, there is a real Kimmy.
Yeah, it's an Essex night out, isn't it? That track, that's sort of what it sounds like to me, something a bit dark and, you know, dirty, drunken night out with the lads.
Highlight of the album, pick up the pieces live. The few times that we only played that two or three times live.
Yeah, we have.
Before, obviously, the tour next month. But live, it's sort of the meanest, heaviest thing that we drop. 99% of the time, this band is kind of tongue-in-cheek and we're not trying to take ourselves too seriously. But there's one or two times in the album that there is a point we're trying to get across. I think Pick Up the Pieces is definitely one of those moments.
Anytime we find.
Pretty much the last song we wrote.
Yeah. It came just after Picking Up Pieces, wasn't it? Those two sort of
wrote
quite paired. Close together, our sort of serious statement on the album.
Two of the Kids was a pain, wasn't it?
Live highlight.
So pain in the arse.
How many versions have we done of that?
A lot. We were constantly trying to up the party in the track. I remember when Dougie came down, he was like, "Just need to feel more like a party."
Last track on the album.
Which was a basic, it's just us lot crying.
And it was like, well, you know, that come from a genuine place where, you know, like we didn't know whether we was going to be signed and we didn't know if all the risks we'd take would be the right decision and justified. And we wrote that one night because we didn't have enough money to go to the pub, so we wrote that instead.
On a Friday night, wasn't it?
On a Friday, we didn't have enough money to go to the pub.
It's a track about broken.
So we just sat around the piano and we wrote it, and then when we wrote it, we said, well, when we record this, we want it to sound like us lot sitting around the piano.
As soon as we knew we was putting the album down, I always...
It was the we knew early on
that was going to be the last track.
Yeah. It's just the perfect tone to an album, I think we're all very proud of. They laid a pain on you.